All right, guys. Normally I would start out with a really huge intro. I'm not exactly sure what to make of some of the stuff that was happening at the end there. We're not really sure what that was. Obviously, great hype video work from Hybrid, but, a lot of strange stuff been happening around EIF lately, aside from the connection issues, which we always have. Another tweet earlier today, I don't know if there's any correlation with it, but we're trying our best to crack the code here. I don't even know. I mean, this is not... I don't know if this is breaking kayfabe. I don't know who this person is. So, EIF's Beast on Twitter, yet again coming out, random times we haven't seen a lot. I know some people have tried to reach out to this Twitter account to try and find out who this person is. We have not gotten any word back from them, but it says, a beast is defined by three characteristics: destruction, dominance, and vengeance. So, I don't know there. I mean, there's a hint at that one. I don't know if it is that person. Obviously, DDV straight down. And it has me thinking. It definitely has a lot of people thinking. So, we're not sure, guys, but we're going to try and figure that out. I'm going to try and contact that person and see. Maybe it is him. We haven't seen DDV since September, so maybe there's a chance. But all right, I got to get back on this. So we're going to let that happen later. So, guys, welcome in to Victory Votes, the 9th annual Victory Votes, Victory Votes 2016. As always, your host, EIF owner Cardi, a great hype video provided by Hybrid, and a great duet of first half and second half commentary by Hybrid and I on that Greedy and Aaron match that had some technical difficulties. And we are going to be kicking off the main card with a championship match, and this match was the first of 7 on the main card voted by you, the viewers, the fans. You guys voted what you wanted to see in this match between a normal False Count Anywhere and Extreme Rules. You voted False Count Anywhere. That's where we are. Guys, go ahead and join. It's time for our Intercontinental Championship match, and the game is up. Tonight's arena for Vengeance is Night of Champions. And for the side note here, for Victory Votes, I think I said Vengeance because didn't I just scroll past it? Is it down here? Or is there no Vengeance on the game? I could have swore there is. Yeah, there it is. Okay, I was wondering why. I just saw it. But I did want to scroll back down here anyway because you guys can see this on my screen. So I did get recommended to do Survivor Series 96. The ropes are red, white, and blue, and yes, I thought about it. I wasn't 100% sure, but I ultimately backed off the idea because the stage was really, really, really small, like practically inexistent, and it does have that kind of grainy background, being that it is an older arena. Pepsi, make sure you are joining the game, please. Pepsi says he's trying. That is not a good thing. Now, there was a triple threat a couple weeks ago where James R. Coffle won to become the champion that he is today to defend the title, but that also featured Nexus Genesis, and in his place is Pepsi Killer, who has been in matches with both of these superstars. Pepsi might have to crash if this continues, and we can always do the one person at a time if we need to, so we apologize for the slow start here to Victory Votes. I think it's going to become very fast and furious in terms of the pacing throughout, though, tonight's broadcast. Pepsi, do you need me to remake it or something? Okay. Here, let me remake it. Guys, let's let Pepsi join first just to take a safety precaution here. Hopefully the best is going to work out here in that we get a triple threat and a False Count Anywhere match. This was voted in, and these three superstars very well could be a big reason for that. Great. Yeah, that's fine. I might do that. So anyway, guys, I remade the match. Let's have Pepsi join first. Best thing to always... That's fine. Best thing to always do is find out if there's a problem between myself and one of the competitors, because that's the biggest red flag. So you have to hope. And 4 weeks ago when we did Collision Course, we did have several connection issues that kind of baffled and battled us out to a two-hour delay. You know, it's really weird, the timing of the Twitch mess-ups and the WWE game mess-ups. They always tend to pinpoint to an EIF pay-per-view, unfortunately. There's probably been a handful since... okay, Pepsi's in, so Midnight and James, if you guys want to try. But there's probably been a handful since, I'd say, the start of the network with Vengeance in April of 2015. A handful of pay-per-views that probably experienced little to no connectivity issues. I guess one of the things that, you know, could result in it, and we said this, I believe, earlier this week, actually, is that WWE games and WWE 2K16 specifically is kind of ran its course. And so, all right, Midnight, are you going to be able to reset your connection or anything?
I mean, it's not the connection in general. It just happens on and off with me and Pepsi.
I mean...
It's on and off between me and Pepsi. Like, that's the
connection. I mean, the thing is, like, Midnight, I understand where you're coming from, dude, but the thing is, yeah, either you or Pepsi, dude, something's going to have to break there, because if not... You know, we can't do anything. So, all right, guys. So, Midnight is going to take a time out here and attempt to restore some connection. Midnight and Pepsi swore that they have connected numerous times outside of EIF. I believe we've actually seen them in an EIF match together. And so that's the kind of way you like to start out a pay-per-view, brother. So let's go ahead and see if we have one of our other matches ready. And something tells me we don't. We will get something going for you guys. I assure you that. And I am sincerely... sorry for this. You know, the way connection issues occur in EIF, you just, they're kind of like RKOs. They happen out of nowhere. You don't see them coming. And I guess we should, given how much problems we're used to at this point. But, you know, it's a great pay-per-view card, guys. We have so many awesome matches booked, and we're really hoping that the execution of them is going to be just as good as the hype and as the excitement geared towards them. But we can only do so much here at EIF. We don't have our own game. We don't have our own platform. So we are very dependent and reliant on Xbox One, Twitch, and WWE 2K16 right now. And unfortunately, it's been painfully obvious, especially over the last month or so, that it is miraculous if those three things end up lining up at the same time. So we're going to continue here. Like I said, you know, we got seven matches still to come, four championship matches. The one of them is going to be temporarily delayed, and we certainly hope we won't have to put any placeholders in there. So we're going to, in the meantime, try to find our next matchup. And let's see if we get it. So invites are being sent out as we speak, guys. We're doing our best to make sure that we can get some people in here. Of course, we do understand there's a number of guys that are actually watching our network that are EIF superstars, so they're getting this message a little delayed because they're watching the live feed. So hopefully they check their Xboxes if they are watching on there. And of course, we're already going to be probably losing some viewership due to UFC 200. Say what you want, man. I didn't know Brock Lesnar was going to return to UFC. So, we're trying to get guys in here right now. I'm trying to get certain superstars to join the party. They are not. And you know, the hardest part about this is when you're timing people and you're trying to tell people, because people always want to know in EIF as a superstar, you know, it's fair to want to know this. But you a lot of times you want to kind of get an idea what time you have to be on. Not everybody is capable or really just, quite frankly, willing to sit on a game for 3 hours. So
is just raping Marin, it's fine. Oh, good. So it's nothing important.
No, not. He literally has his junk on his other junk. They're just kind of
literally
like
the only matches that are important are Cormier versus Silva, Lesnar versus Hunt, and Tate versus Nunez.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of that, Tate, who do you,
All right, guys. So Midnight Mayfire did get back on. You know, nobody else is really trying anything right now, so I guess we'll just go ahead and work with these guys. Nobody else has attempted to join the game, or I'm sorry, join the party, rather. That's what I've been trying to get people to do, but clearly no response. But, you know, we sometimes tell guys, like, hey, you know, be ready around 8:45. I know, be ready around 8:45, be ready around 9. Yeah, Untamed does want to join, but Wicked isn't online now. So, you know, he was on... I texted Wicked too, but we'll see. So, all right, Midnight, you ready to try it again? All right, let's go ahead and try this out. Pepsi, are you and James already on the game? All right, Midnight, are you on? Servers are down. All right, so the servers are acting up for Midnight, but hopefully that isn't anything of too much significance. We do have another announcement for you guys. Tripod's featured fight tonight, as revealed on the pre-show, would be against a rookie superstar. Well, that superstar is going to be a superstar who Tripod has now jostled back and forth with for wins earlier this week on tour. They've had some very entertaining matches. People have liked them. And for the pay-per-view watchers tonight that did not get a chance to watch any of the action on tour or missed any of those particular matches, it's going to be Tripod versus Nexus Genesis here tonight. So it is a 1-1 series between the two of them. DZ, thanks for joining. Midnight, your servers are still down.
My servers are up. Are you not watching?
By the way, guys, I don't know if it's like if it's giving you guys any screen issues or whatnot. Just give me some time. I'm just sending some messages. He might be. I mean, I told Wicked to just be on around 8:45, 9 o'clock, so. Hello, DZ. Well, the fast and furious pace to victory votes is that of Franklin the Turtle from Nick Jr.'s early 2000s, late 90s TV show. Nostalgia, people. That's how we draw people. Ask Friday the 13th game makers. All right, Midnight, your servers are back up. All right, let's go ahead and give it. Let's give it one more whirl here. If this does not work, we're gonna go jump over to the Tripod Nexus match and then try and recircle back to the IC one more time. If that doesn't work, guess what, guys? We got a replacement for the IC because unfortunately we have to do that. So the match is up. Pepsi, Midnight, James, please go ahead and try and join. This is ED Rules, Falls Count Anywhere, voted by you, the viewers. You got to vote not only the stipulation, but the brand that stipulation would be contested under. The IC title is our only cross-brand championship in EIF. That might be why it's so popular and what makes it so hard to hold. James R. Coffle, we're hoping you are not the odd man out this time because Midnight and Pepsi are in, as are you, and hope has risen in the EIF rafters, as has it in the Twitch chat. Here we go, guys. Let's hope. Again, the only way to win on ED is by pinfall. Superstardom would have allowed a submission possibility. Midnight Mayfire as Tyson Kidd might have had the advantage, as would have Pepsi with the sleeper hold. So whether this benefits the champion, James, or not, well, guys, that remains to be seen. But we are loading in. We'll get in-ring introductions for all our matches tonight, except select matches towards the end of our broadcast, which were picked to include entrances. The first of four championship matches, and more importantly, the opener to the main card of victory votes, we are desperately hoping is just a mere moment or two away. Also, guys, this is the first of two multi-man matches announced on the pre-show. We'll have a Money in the Bank qualifying match. That, too, will be ED, and it will be a multi-man. I can confirm that Beatdown and DZ will be a part of the Money in the Bank qualifying match here tonight. The winner getting an opportunity to compete at SummerSlam in the Money in the Bank ladder match. And from there, if that superstar wins, well, guys, knowing the knowledge of DZ and possibly Beatdown, knowing the knowledge of both these guys and the fact that they are former world champions, you can almost guarantee another reign would be added to their resumes. So we begin to hear the crowd, whether you can or not, due to the game volume as well as 2K16's disinclusion of theme songs. I don't know if that affects the game volume right here. But we're hoping it takes a little bit. It is ED again. This was voted in by you guys, maybe to some surprise. Superstardom tends to have better connection than ED does. And so taking an ED multi-man also means taking a risk, especially if any of these guys have the dreaded PT. And that means paint tool, custom logos, imported data, whatever you may call it. It is problematic, as always. A new rule has actually been added to our EIF website for superstars that use created wrestlers. You might want to reference yourself with that. The qualifier is ED and the match is Superstardom for Money in the Bank. So, the following contest is a Falls Count Anywhere Triple Threat Match for the EIF Intercontinental Championship. Introducing the challengers, starting in the top left, from Detroit, Michigan, Midnight Mayfair. One time. Standing across the ring to his left, from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, he is the second challenger. He is Pepsi Killer. And their opponent from Florida, the current reigning and defending EIF Intercontinental Champion, James R. Cuffo. All right, one taunt for Midnight and James, none for Pepsi. This Falls Count Anywhere match for the Intercontinental Championship is underway. Ding, ding, ding. And here we go. To the outside goes Midnight, looking to have a repeat of him and Deathlock, who tore the roof back on the place and the fans out of the seats 4 weeks ago. And by out of the seats, I mean back to the parking lot and out of here. They kicked off Collision Course. So either way, Midnight Mayfire, though, looking to be a four-time Intercontinental Champion Pepsi Killer. Actually, Pepsi, are you also looking to be a four-time? How many have you held? You're looking to be a six-time. God damn. This is just James's second championship reign. He won it in his first title match for the belt. Midnight Mayfire was the defending champion. Nexus Genesis reared his head into that situation. Didn't work out, though. And again, voted by the fans, a Falls Count Anywhere matchup here. That means no disqualification, people. And the only way to win by making this ED is by pinfall off of a finisher or, of course, a reversal leverage pin. As Pepsi Killer begins to rearrange the furniture, the first weapon of the night brought out, I have a feeling many will be introduced. And a chair shot to the ribs. And wait, Pepsi's not done. Fellow challenger DDT'd head first on the steel chair. The champion to the outside, and Midnight Mayfire will painfully have to endure the whippings, basically, of that steel chair from Pepsi. But James Arcavo also has it, and Pepsi says twice as nice. Another DDT head first. Thank goodness play jobs are illegal in EIF now. And James and Pepsi kill. Well, Midnight Mayfire has just became the battering ram for chair shots. Champion, though, coming in with a backbreaker to Pepsi Killer. And now James backing away to the outside. Midnight Mayfire is there to greet him, and James able to Spider-Man his way out of here. Oh, wait a minute. Pepsi reverse STO, and James goes down in the chair. And now Midnight Mayfire taking advantage. Well, guys, you wanted this. You voted for it. You asked for it, and you got it. Weapons allowed in this Intercontinental Championship opener. Pepsi Killer essentially just playing keep away right now with the chair. And look at how healthy Pepsi is compared to his opposition and fellow challenger Midnight and defending champion James. Another neck breaker from Pepsi Killer. James, oh, wait a minute. Midnight with the baseball bat. James Arcoffel looks like he's going to be a victim. The MLB All-Star break is coming up soon, and it looks like Midnight's going to go slugging a little early. And again, the bat, this time right across the jawline of James. Might need a surgical repairman for that. Midnight will discard the baseball bat, and now his second taunt shot right over to me. Pepsi Killer to the outside. James, once again, will go to the outside as well. James with the baseball bat looking to return the favor on Midnight Mayfire. Midnight Mayfire avoids the shot, and Pepsi Killer took it for him. Running grapple connects for the most recent former IC champion in Midnight. Gotta love how this match has had an extreme start to it. You gotta commend these guys for putting in that effort. Not everybody wanting to get dirty with the weapons. And you know, last pay-per-view we had four championships on the line as well. Collision Course 4 weeks ago. All four of those titles changing hands that night. And you gotta wonder, with four belts on the line tonight, if the same fate could await. And that is not spelling good for James Arcoffel. He'll early on tonight look to rid that question. So finishers in hand for everybody but the champion, who is the most damaged in Pepsi Killer, though, adding to Midnight Mayfire's frustration badge. Shout out to Cole Cabana Podcast and some good old-fashioned wrestling from James Arcoffel to Midnight Mayfire. Pushing him down, here comes Pepsi Killer from behind with a reverse Frankensteiner. Dropkick from Midnight to bridge the gap in reach between he and fellow challenger. Nice dropkick again for Midnight Mayfire. Well, James Arcoffel just having a tough time here. We said right before this match started that maybe he would actually end up with an advantage had it been voted ED, because of the fact that he was the only character in Superstar in between these three that does not have a submission finisher. He had Shawn Michaels, but it doesn't look like anything, though, is really benefiting James right now. The IC champion in his first defense with the title, just his second title in EIF, and another waistlock hold on the ground. I was going to say a takedown, but they had already been down as a blue thunderbomb connects for Toronto Blue in Pepsi Killer, though he is wearing just plain country Canada colors in the red and white. Black is an addition of choice, and Pepsi Killer with the Seth Walker, that also of his own selection. James Arcoffel with a reversal. The champion has plenty of time still to rebound in this match as Midnight Mayfire gets back to the apron, and James looking for the axe handle, but it's reversal battles between these two. Midnight Mayfire trying to get involved there, and he cannot, but James gets caught with a swinging neckbreaker from Pepsi Killer. Already into recovery mode goes James. However, this will help him in momentum. Pepsi will not allow that any longer. James, though, with a reversal, takes him down. Midnight Mayfire and James both missing each other, and then a released German suplex connecting for Midnight to the champion. Looking for that single leg takedown to Pepsi Killer. And once again, Pepsi with these inverted suplexes, inverted back suplexes. Well, we thought we would see Suplex City tonight, but I think we believed that would be coming from NBC Master, not Pepsi Killer. Either way, you get it. Suplex City might be coming to UFC tonight with Brock Lesnar and Mark Hunt on the UFC 200 card. We're sorry that we are interfering in that, but we're hoping that you make some time for us tonight on your busy watch night here on Saturday the 9th of July. July 9th marking the 9th annual Victory Votes pay-per-view. Already so much going on, over 750 votes casted from you, the viewers, which we thank you so much for participating in our yearly July Classic. We revealed all those polls, had a great match between Aaron and Greedy with an unfortunate ending. a dissatisfactory no contest. And hey, how about the announcement of the podcast with Raymond and Anthony returning to the EIF broadcast and debuting on the EIF network for the first time in 2 years. They returned to EIF, and for the first time they are on the network as Midnight Mayfire with a Seth Walker into the pinfall. Pepsi has it as a regular move. Midnight has it as a finisher, but it's not going to finish this match, at least not yet. Victory votes tonight is marks 2 years since the last time Raymond and Anthony stepped in the EIF's squared circle. Victory votes 2014 was when we last saw them. And I'm sure it'll be very interesting to see them in just 1 week. Oh, wait a minute. Midnight Mayfire. Signature connects. And remember, guys, the champion does not need to be pinned. This is the only multi-man for a championship tonight, and James Arcaval does not have to be the one with his shoulders to the mat for 3 seconds for this title to change hands. Pepsi going off the rope, and always battered into the corner, seated, and Midnight Mayfire going to bring him out. Pepsi not going to have any more of that. Pepsi with the baseball bat, and it's time to go swinging. Toronto's got a baseball team, too, in the Blue Jays, so why can't he partake? Already 20-plus viewers in early on. We apologize for those technical difficulties that happened, but we're glad you stayed with us. You're tuning in to EIF's 9th Annual Victory Votes and the Intercontinental Championship in a triple threat match with the champion James defending against Pepsi Killer and Midnight Mayfire, the only vote-oriented pay-per-view of the year, and this has been voted in as an Extreme Distortion-branded Falls Count Anywhere match. Which, as you guys can tell, has been pretty extreme so far. I would say Pepsi has obviously had the biggest edge in this in terms of health, obviously. That is, I guess, evident there. But Midnight Mayfire did hit the only finisher that resulted in a pinfall attempt. He got a one count in on the champ before Pepsi interrupted it. And now Midnight just staying on the outside. Still to come, the U.S. Championship, two main event titles on the line. We've got the Hollywood Open Challenge for the first time on pay-per-view. So much going on, including this Seth Walker from Pepsi, and it was the stolen finisher of Midnight Mayfire. Do we have a new champion? We do! Pepsi Killer! A six-time Intercontinental Champion. Midnight Mayfire can't kick out of one measly finisher. I cannot tell you guys how many times this happens on pay-per-view, but on the regular shows, he'll kick out of 7. But here, it's a one and done, and just like that, title match number 1, title change number 1, Pepsi Killer is the 6-time Intercontinental Champion, tying him with GTA Fan for the most Intercontinental title reigns in EIF history. Is he a part of the preview program? Well, look, man, if the parties don't work, you're just going to have to deal with it because, I mean, you know. All right, guys, so we have a title change. Now let's go and shift our focus to Prismatic Nebula. He's a former Intercontinental Champion. In fact, the longest reigning IC champion in EIF history. And tonight in his featured fight, it was voted in by you guys. You wanted to see Prismatic Nebula, the EIF veteran, face an EIF rookie. Well, he's been facing a rookie. He's actually fought him twice already this week on EIF Tour. They had 2 hotly contested matchups, each winning 1. And now it's time for the rubber match here on Victory Votes. Prismatic Nebula going one-on-one with Nexus Genesis. And we understand there are going to be some party difficulties tonight. Those that are part of the Xbox preview program, there's been an update that's resulting in some very tough issues to overcome. But guys, if you are listening in on the broadcast, you're part of the preview program, and you're going to be having a match tonight, anybody that's been booked tonight is pretty knowledgeable when it comes to EIF, so you guys shouldn't have to worry about breaking the rules. We might need you guys to be out of the party in order to get the match to work. So anyway, Greedy actually requested to watch this match. That doesn't help. All This is probably a fitting pay-per-view this year. It's election year. This is the third time that EIF has had a Victory Votes pay-per-view during the election year. The match is up, guys. Go ahead and join. I have tried inviting Nexus. I understand that, and I have tried inviting him. So if Nexus is very... No, we don't. We have Nexus Genesis, who actually knows how to play the EIF rules. So Nexus, go ahead and join, brother. It is your time. And Greedy will be watching with me. And Nexus, man, if you start having more issues, brother, just, you know how to play the game. You know the EIF rules. Just roll with it, okay? Mm-hmm. Whoa. Well, Tripod with certainly a different character on this holiday. I knew that it was the election year, and I knew that in EIF you could vote. I didn't think this was the Purge election year, but apparently Tripod just got into his first rated R movie the other night, and it inspired him. So, couple years back, Victory Votes, Tripod did wear a masked superstar, but a little bit of a different version this time. Now, like I said, guys, each of these superstars, Nexus and Tripod, had one win over each other on tour. And, you know, some rivalries go down in history through what happens on tour. Think about Jinto and GTA. We just brought him up a bit ago, now tied with Pepsi Killer for the most IC title reigns. GTA actually did it over the span of two eras because the Intercontinental title had actually been defunct for a few years. GTA had, I believe, four reigns with the title. Then it became defunct, and he came back and had a couple with it. In fact, GTA's final match in EIF to date was for the Intercontinental Championship back at WrestleMania 8 against good friend Hostile Exile, who was unable to be here. Hostile Exile, also known, and Hostile and GTA, in fact, I can't bring up the KWO enough. Those guys tore the house down back in 2012 in a Victory Votes main event. The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, in the top left corner, from New York, Nexus Genesis! And his opponent, one's on for Nexus, from St. Louis, Missouri, Prismatic Nebula! All right, guys, ding, ding, ding. And here we go. Opening between these two. And is just the second time Nexus is on pay-per-view here in EIF. So, and is actually his first main card match on an EIF pay-per-view. Following the pre-show back in May. And that's just another example of a guy who just hasn't been given the rub yet in EIF. But man, is he good. And he's actually forced Tripod already to use, I believe that was a reversal, correct? And, oh, wait a minute, look at this Tripod. Well, he's unraveling our announce table. I don't know how many times this may happen tonight. And, oh, what's his Nexus Genesis over the top, and he caught Tripod, but not enough. Well, I did not see that coming. Nexus practically tackled the referee, and these guys, refs down. Well, they can keep going. Nexus is going to throw Tripod right back in here. Boot to the side of the head of Tripod. And Tripod, I think, hit his head off that turnbuckle, that bottom turnbuckle there in that corner. Nexus will turn the EIF Hall of Famer onto his stomach and then pick him up. Arm drag reversal for Tripod. Genesis with a reversal. Tripod kicking him right back. Great athleticism from a guy in real life who can't move his foot a foot 6 inches above the ground. and dropping the head of Genesis into the canvas. Brutality, the COO watching on from Twitch. Welcome in, Mr. COO, on a busy week, I'm sure, that included a lot of illegal hammer shots on a certain game featuring anime characters such as Kirby, Pikachu, and more. Shout out to Armada. Genesis with a neckbreaker to Tripod. Armada never was in EIF, so I don't know how the hell he's EIF's beast. But either way, Genesis powerbombing Tripod from the ground up and now dropping the legs right into the midsection of Tripod. I didn't think there was anything there, but judging by Tripod's reaction, there must be. Tripod, STO delivered. Great example, veteran superstar of 5 years versus the superstar of less than 5 months. And Genesis, painful arm breaker. Genesis actually less than 5 months, actually 3 months in EIF to date, just about. Maybe closer to four, I don't know. Genesis going for a wicked headbutt. Tripod saw it. And oh, beautiful reversal though from Nexus into that clothesline. Now Nexus picking Tripod up. Another neck breaker connecting for him. Not connect. Connecting. Xbox connect. Genesis stomping on the ribs of Tripod. Finisher in hand for Genesis. And Tripod is a little bit worried. Genesis was maybe thinking green bar. Tripod's experienced that feeling twice in the last week or so from NBC Master. And, oh, he's still got it. Genesis still has it, and I think that's going to put it away. Ground and pound offense from Tripod. Nexus is out of green. But more importantly, though, he can still win this match. So that's a huge opportunity for Nexus two times in 1 week to beat a two-time undisputed Superstorm champion. And, uh-oh, he looks like he's going to send Tripod straight to hell with that chokeslam, but Tripod mutilating that offense. Signature in hand now for the EIF's newest Hall of Fame superstar, and a patented Orton stomp being used, and this debilitates just about every limb and body part on Genesis. Tripod bringing up Genesis once again. A little bit of lag here. And oh, what a nice power bomb from Tripod. Now we've seen some new moves here from this new side of Tripod here tonight at Victory Votes. That's your second taunt, right? Or first. Okay. Oh, yeah, Genesis was the one that did the taunt at the beginning of the match. Genesis pushing Tripod away. And, oh, really technical match for a game that limits you to reversals. Knee to the ribs from Tripod. And a spin around the clothesline. Genesis practically did a flip there, and he will do a rollout this time, his first of the match. Will clean entry be awarded to Genesis? I think not. Back in, here comes Nexus. Running close. Oh, and look at that. Smart move from Tripod. That's a free move. Tripod cannot grapple from the apron. Is that three free moves or just one, guys? Okay. All right, that's fair. All right, Genesis wants the hit in the ring, so Genesis will get one free move, guys. It is illegal in EIF to grapple while on the apron. If you were the guy in the ring, it is okay. By the way, are you guys proud that I actually knew that rule? That's why you were trying to get away with the Tripod, Mr. Manipulator, Mr. Controversy. Talk about Raymond and Tony being controversial. Tripod's known for that as well. Oh, that's a good one. I like that. Well, guys, don't forget, later on tonight we have the Money in the Bank qualifier. Tag Team Tournament Opener was an option there, but we will see the Tag Team Tournament open here in these next coming weeks. 12 teams total, 24 superstars battling for an opportunity. Tripod and Greedy, a team. I believe Nexus and Midnight are a team as well. And Nexus with a taunt. Signaling the end here, possibly, for this match. We've seen him use that taunt on Tripod before. Goes for the finisher. Tripod saw it coming, and a finisher reversal. Nexus saying, you finally did it, because he hit that patently on Tripod, who reverts to the outside. And yet again, we have Tripod taking apart another announce table. The usage is for broadcast purposes and not dissembling. Well, Tripod's got to be careful here that he doesn't get disqualified, guys. Falls Count Anywhere was the match that had no DQ. This match does not fall under that same category, and he nearly hit the damn ref. This is where Tripod can end up losing it. You got to wonder, this new character maybe showing a bit of the psychology going on through the head of Tripod. Genesis will take care of the steps and take care of Tripod as he was planning on maybe using that for offensive purposes. Genesis now choking the life out of Tripod, and he's going to get his second obtained finisher. The first one was reversed. And Genesis predictably going for it again. Tripod reverse, and oh, what a reversal though for Genesis. Back and forth we go. Great one-on-one matchup between these two thus far. We talked about how stacked of a card Victory Votes was looking to be. And Genesis going downstairs on Tripod again. This is the third match this week between these two. Genesis able to get in here based on the rookie voting selection by you, the viewers, and whether you guys thought we were going to see Genesis or not, there were some rumors floating around as soon as the vote got confirmed. People were hoping for a rematch between these two because of how good it's been, and now with roughly 30 viewers on hand, the most to these matchups between these two thus far this week, they are getting to put on a show. Genesis, such an exciting new superstar in EIF, adding a hybrid yet old-school dynamic to the league. And I didn't, when I said hybrid, I did not mean hybrid maniac. When I said dynamic, I did not mean Raymond or Anthony's new gamer tag. Tripod again, targeting the arm of Nexus Genesis. Painfully, I might add. It certainly looks it. That's a move I would not want to see done in real life. Tripod back to the ground and pound on the face mask of Genesis. Tripod backing up, giving some time. He's got to be careful about stalling here. He does the smart move, the veteran move, allowing Genesis to make some movement. Nexus, though, able to drop kick the leg, and another spine buster delivered. Well, Genesis is 0 for 2 on attempted finishers. Tripod has two finishers, and Genesis has got another one. Does he go for it again? He does. And he's going to hit it. Tombstone pile driver. Shoulders down. Here we go. Does Nexus have the win? 1, 2. And Tripod kicks out. 1-0 finisher count, though, in favor of the Young Buck Nexus. Oh, the Shining Wizard. How about a shout-out to Shane Helms? I know he'll never watch EIF Network, but you know what? There's no way he's got anything better to do right now. Last time I saw him was TNA. And he's a manager. Doesn't even wrestle. Oh, Genesis with an awkward headbutt. I think that caught the neck of Tripod. Discomforting way to get hit. 1-0 finisher count. Two taunts for Tripod. Two taunts for Genesis. One of a more emphatic kind. Don't really have to read in between the lines. Nexus's third taunt. But you don't really have to read in between the lines there. Tripod again, trying to tempt with fate here, potentially. And you don't want to, I mean, you already had a match end in a no contest. You had a match end off one finisher. You don't want to see a match end off a disqualification here. And Tripod, oh, toppling Genesis over the top rope. End to the outside again. Third taunt for Tripod to even up that score. And a 1-0 finisher count in favor of the rookie Nexus Genesis. Genesis getting in the ring. No clean entry allowed. And Tripod telling him he had to take the opportunity. And this is how Tripod plays, guys. This is how Tripod plays his style in EIF. It's no honor. It's disrespectful. And he has to do it against a guy who has 5 years less played. Just about 5 years less played than him. Tripod still yet to hit a finisher. 35 viewers in here on this matchup between Tripod and Genesis. Tripod picking up Nexus. Nexus with a right body shot. And you never know who's going to watch on this broadcast. A lot of times it's EIF Superstars. Sometimes it's our fans. Sometimes it's part of our alumni. Shout out to SG15 Raiders, who's here with us watching on the EIF Network, a former Extreme champion. And he can appreciate, while being a former Extreme Champion, he can appreciate matches like this that don't necessarily need weapons. Tripod has tried to influence Genesis to use them, but to no avail. And Genesis, with another reversal and another big boot, you knew Tripod didn't want to use that reversal. Nexus Genesis confirming that that is the legal big boot. We're going to get a production truck review, I'm sure, when they see it. We might get a comment. We'll determine if, so far, so good, silence. And so I believe this will be a good move. And Genesis, right before gaining that second reversal, well, he's out of reversals, but he is now also out of finishers because he hit this one. 2-0 finisher count. Go to sleep, shoulders down, hooks the leg. 1-2, he's looking to beat Tripod again this week, and Tripod says no. Genesis, once again, going to the outside. 2-0 finisher count for Nexus. Take a look at the carnage on that side of the ring. Tripod running into the referee, and yet again, he is down. Now, Tripod and the ref have not gotten along well in this match. A steps shot. Nexus actually hit the ref too, and Nexus with a decapitating boot as Tripod walked right into it. Man, what a match here on Victory Votes these two are putting on. Possibly their best one yet. Nexus picking up Tripod, back body drop delivered. Yeah, we've certainly seen some variety in this match that we're not as used to. And Tripod did not go for the finisher. Genesis almost had his reversal back. And now Tripod, finisher, right there. 2-1 finisher count, this Genesis fall. 1-2, Nexus has to get his shoulder off the mat, and he does. But look at Tripod's momentum, guys. Tripod might still be able to get one off on Genesis, and he's going to tie the count and add insult to injury. He's stealing the finisher, and Nexus Genesis. Is Genesis going to lose to his own device? 1-2. And Genesis holds on. And what is Tripod doing now? Oh, painful choke to Genesis. Yet again, another move we have not seen. Tripod with Genesis on the ropes. And what is next? Oh, Genesis thrown to the outside. Tripod says, we're going Extreme James. Wrong opponent, dumbass. And now, in between the middle rope, cannonball, though, out, plunging onto Genesis as if it were shot right out of a ship. Tripod continuing the offense. And now, Genesis thrown into the barricade. And Tripod just pummeling down now on the young superstar here in EIF, known as Nexus Genesis. Previous gamertag, Stewie Cartman, a fan of South Park. We told him to change his gamertag. He hesitated, but it has been one of the better decisions he has made in his career as an Xbox One gamer, an Xbox Live gamer, and now an EIF superstar, his fourth taunt. Count at 5. Tripod could lose this match by count out. Tripod back into the ring. Nexus Genesis back to the offense. Well, Tripod didn't give Genesis clean entry. Can you expect the returning of the favor? Yes, you can. And that is where Genesis is now. We've seen Genesis do this earlier in the match, from the ground up and back down to the ground with a very strong powerbomb. And Genesis is not out of taunts. It did not complete. He did not get the momentum. So Tripod attempting comeback. Genesis pinfall reversal into leverage pin. 1-2. And Genesis just beat Tripod. Genesis with his second win over Tripod, and they're back to back. Both men back to their feet, but it was a leverage pin that did it. Two finishers from each. Who would have thought that? But Genesis with a quick roll up, and what a match there in front of 30 plus live viewers. Tripod falling victim to the rookie superstar Nexus Genesis. Did you say James again? Jesus. Well, Tripod may be botching, but surprisingly, I didn't too often throughout that match.
Damn, man.
Well, you beat a two-time undisputed Superstar champion and a Hall of Famer. You have to get somewhat accommodations or recognition, and hopefully for Genesis, that is going to begin sooner than later. Coming up next, folks, it is time for our second championship match of the night. It is a rematch from Collision Course. Wicked Jr. will be defending the championship against the man he beat 4 weeks ago, and that is Untamed Legend. Now, we took to the voting polls. It was one of the later polls that was released, asking you guys the same question we asked for the Intercontinental title match, except these are all Superstar matches, of course. And we asked, what stipulation? Normal, Extreme Rules, False Count Anywhere. Well, the Intercontinental title won the vote of False Count Anywhere, but who could have expected the normal to win, because it didn't here either. And so, it is going to be an Extreme Rules matchup. Sorry, guys, if you can't see my screen, I'm just sending a message. All right, is Untamed Legend in the party? All right, anybody want to watch with me?
I'm watching.
Greedy called watching. All right.
I'm watching. I'm watching Ratlick match.
Greedy, you call. How can you call watching the? Yeah, Tribot called the main event. Oh yeah, that is true. Technically, you can. He did. He is the reason why we have this pay-per-view. Although, actually, wait a minute. I just realized something. No, Ratluck watches the main events, because Ratluck will go from entrances right in. He'll make it easier. Oh, actually, you know what, Greedy? You don't even have to watch this match, because it's Extreme Rules, so I'm just going to make it Triple Threat. It'll be one less guy to load in. It's one less guy to load in, dude. It's better for the league, not for you. All right, guys, the match is up. Please go ahead and join Untamed Legend and Wicked Jr. Hideo Itami and John Cena, a match you probably won't end up seeing in WWE, but in the fantasy world of EIF, it is a reality. It was a painful one, actually, for the Cena representative in Untamed Legend just 4 weeks ago. He's got to hope for a better outing, but he's going to maybe be able to have some weapons that could handicap the legs of Untamed that we've learned, or of Wicked that we've learned are so powerful. The match is made, Wicked. Please join.
There's a lot of new people in here. You should probably mention if you like what you've seen, follow us.
So while we await for Wicked to go ahead and join, guys, we want to remind you that don't forget, this: if you enjoyed that last match, which I think all of us did, you can be a part of matches like that by going on to leaguelineup.com/EIFLives and finding out more about our league, including how to join, because you too can be one of the superstars featured here tonight on EIF Victory Votes. Maybe not tonight specifically, but for the future, you can be one of the guys that we're going to see here on the EIF Network, that we're going to see wrestle, that can win championships. Become a part of Extreme International Fighting today. And maybe, just maybe, you might convince the U.S. champion, Wicked Jr., to join the fucking game.
Pursued ASP talk shit on me. Hell no!
What did he say?
God.
He said you can't get. We have a number of superstars in EIF. Wicked, ready up, please. Hey, Tripod, get out of the party. Hey, somebody, Tripod, kick yourself out of the party. We can't be dealing with that, man. 911? Yes, I need a wambulance right away. That's why I wanted him to stop.
I'm sorry.
Hybrid's the mod. He's in control. All right, the following contest is an Extreme Rules match and is contested for the EIF United States Championship. Introducing the challenger first, representing John Cena from Glastonbury, Connecticut. He is Untamed Legend. And his opponent, from Wisconsin, representing Hideo Itami, the current reigning and defending EIF United States Champion, Wicked Junior. All right, Untamed, do you want to focus on him or no? All right. Ding, ding, ding. Second championship match underway. The first one changed hands. The last five pay-per-view championship matches have changed hands. Scratch that. Six. And Wicked going off. It's footwork time for the U.S. champion. Both men with four reversals. Untamed Legend has the opportunity to use weapons that he did not have in his championship defense. So he goes for a reversal on the kicks. There will be a heavy eye kept on the kicks of Wicked Jr. just to ensure that he is not overly spamming them. Wicked nearly green barred Untamed in their first match. This is Untamed, his rematch clause for the championship. Elbow to the face, reversal for Wicked. And yet again, more kicks right to the face of Untamed Legend. Spinarama back fist connects as well. Untamed, you gotta wonder if, I think maybe his best bet here might be getting to the outside with the champion, trying to neutralize him there. Hurricane Rana connects. Untamed Legend telling the game that he did something that the game said he didn't. And while that may sound a little ridiculous to some of you, I'm honestly not that surprised given this game. Retaining a lot of viewers from that great match between Nexus and Tripod that we just saw. Wicked Jr. not so concerned about quality, more about quantity in terms of wins. And Untamed having to roll off two reversals there, and he went early on the grapple, but fortunately for him, he is able to gain a grapple there. Wicked Jr. just about to gain his fourth reversal back. I wonder if he'll allow it, and he does. Smart move from him. He immediately uses it, and he's in a safe position to do so. Running DDT, and he's got a signature. Well, this match was voted in Extreme Rules. Untamed actually as having the rematch clause. This is one of the matches he put as a stipulation, and he is the one not taking advantage of it. He's hung up on the middle rope. Wicked Jr. again. Just, it's unbelievable the power of the character Hideo Itami. You know, but Untamed Legend, I mean, he's got to get out. He's got to find something here. Obviously, these reversals are not working out for him. It is literally almost a replica of what happened to him 4 weeks ago, and he's out of reversals again. Bad time to do so. He isn't kicking you that much, dude. You're just not, like, he actually isn't spamming the kicks as much. That's all right. Maybe one day. Oh, wait a minute. Wicked Jr. with the finisher looking for the green bar. He gets the go to sleep, but he isn't able to go over there and pin Untamed. He's going to have to try right here. One, two, no. Untamed may use comeback, but not the smartest move on his end. You know, Untamed earlier this week actually beat former Intercontinental Champion James in a one-on-one. I had thought maybe we would see a different side of Untamed, but just not fighting back here tonight. Hurricane Rana. You don't get a promotion to a title if you keep losing here, bud. Wicked, calm down on that move. That's all right. Warning issued out to Wicked. Recovery mode indeed needed for Untamed Legend. Well, from back and forth to 95 or 98-2 in terms of the offense for Wicked. Double arm suplex from Wicked. I agree, Hideo is a great character. There's no denying that. I don't know that he's necessarily this good, or if Untamed Legend is just polishing him up. Well, there's a reversal for Untamed. Undoubtedly, Wicked will probably use one, but nice move there from Untamed to try and sideswipe him. Another stomp. Oh, and this time, smart move from Untamed, but oh wait, he does keep the offense. And good for him, he was actually able to get Wicked to use a couple of reversals. Untamed having to adjust here, though. Already had to kick out of one finisher. He has a signature now. He's got to keep reversals, though, just in case Wicked attempts a finisher. Last time he had no reversals when Wicked went for the finisher. Stomp, Wicked using a reversal, and Wicked trying to attack Untamed. Untamed has Wicked now out of reversals, a good position for the challenger. And he can't reverse the finisher, though. 2-0 finisher count for Wicked, who is still in green, and with a 2-0 finisher count, does he green bar Untamed to win the title and retain it? He does! Wicked Jr. with a green bar! Untamed Legend, back-to-back pay-per-views where he gets decimated from Wicked. A brief chance for a comeback there, but Wicked will extend this reign beyond 28 days. And Wicked trying to get... You can't, dude. Well, actually, you have title shots. You could. All right, man. Well, hey, Untamed, that was an excellent outing for you. Wicked Jr., congrats on the win. And Wicked Jr. retains the United States Championship. A green bar might have been his first ever. I was even more, I thought you had like a 3-month reign. I think you had a 3-month reign. So 3-month reign with the exhibition, by the way, guys. I know audio isn't included, but all right, guys. Well, coming up next, it's another multi-man, and it is time for a Money in the Bank ladder match qualifier. There will be 5 superstars, and under superstar rules, those superstars will compete at SummerSlam, EIF's 10th annual SummerSlam, 5 weeks from today. If they retrieve a briefcase, they get a guaranteed future world championship match anytime, anywhere, any place for either world championship. The match itself, the ladder match itself, will feature superstardom characters. The qualifiers will feature ED characters, and that's where we are headed next, as it will be a multi-man. Beatdown is not in the party, I don't think. I will invite him back. Hopefully, he is still online. I do not see him online. Reasons to panic. Hey. That's not allowed. I hope he didn't leave. Yeah, I mean, he might be appearing offline. Qualifier eventually. This will be a triple threat qualifier, by the way, guys. Beatdown was last seen 1 minute ago.
Oh, no, that means he's not appearing offline. Is that like Pepsi shows it to a show? Can I just, like, use it or something?
Mm-hmm. So, guys, sorry if there is a temporary delay here. Beatdown did tell us he was going somewhere tonight, but I was under the impression he would be here for this match. Volt times to leave. DZ will be competing in this Money in the Bank qualifier. It will be his 575th EIF match to record. He is the superstar who holds the most matches among all superstars in EIF history. And Beatdown would have been a lovely addition to this match, giving another hopeful run, but he's not on So that opportunity is being passed up upon. We'll see if anybody else ends up joining. The invite has been sent to other superstars as well as Beatdown's account, just in case he was maybe appearing offline. We will not be doing a one-on-one for this. We can tell you that much, folks. A multi-man. And I will say, though, the rest of the qualifiers will be one-on-ones. They will all take place at SummerSlam. All right. Tyron Hunt, I need you. Pay-per-view. Can you do it? It's a Money in the Bank qualifying match. Great. All right, guys, so it's going to be Tyron Hunt, DZ, and E-Bams. This is the consolation prize qualifying match. Three superstars that you probably would call dark horses when it comes to a Money in the Bank ladder match, but the reality is one of them, barring any connection issues, will get that opportunity. So we are going to give Tyron a brief moment here to get on the game. DZ, you are a dark horse based on skill, but I will say in brains, you may be the genius of the Money in the Bank. However, to be fair, you have not won one despite being in multiple. DZ, how many Money in the Banks have you been in the EIF? Three? Definitely three in my head, I'm thinking. WrestleMania 6, WrestleMania 7, right? Seven was the really, really, really good one. Six was the really, really good one. But Tyron, you said you're on the servers?
I know I was on the
Okay. All right, guys, it's time to make the match. Tyron, you were in a Money in the Bank before, so Ebams will be looking to get his first. You can't. It's a triple threat, dumbass. Anyway, I made the match, guys. Go ahead and join. By the way, for the one I called dumbass, that was referring to Greedy, who asked if he could watch this match. I can tell you guys that the match is up, and you can watch it on the EIF Network, but he wanted to watch it directly through the game feed. That's not going to happen. What is going to happen is the match is already up, and so hopefully DZ, Tyron, and Ebams will all join. Ebams will be looking for an opportunity to get in his first ever Money in the Bank ladder match. Tyron Hunt's been a part of one. DZ has been a part of multiple, and they all competed at one at WrestleMania. This is only going to be the second SummerSlam in EIF history that has had Money in the Bank ladder matches. Yeah, they both are. Oh, God. Why, Beatdown? Why did you have to go? I shouldn't even mention him on the network because of this. DZ, didn't you say you've had to try it, like, multiple times before?
Oh, execution. Yeah, there's sometimes that it'll join on the second try, but... Raider said he'll join.
That starts tonight, doesn't
it? What does?
No. This match is...
Doesn't?
It was in a poll. It was either that, this match, or a Piggy in the Bank match, and this match won.
Would Trap Hot be a Piggy in the Bank? Here's your thing.
Trap Hot is a little piggy.
All right, guys, so we are waiting. Just a little bit of connection issues here. Bothersome, aren't they? We have to wait and see here. Things are not looking good. All right, you try crashing. Guys, let me remake it. And DZ, when you're back on the game, Ebams and Tyron, you guys wait, and we'll do maybe the one-at-a-time thing. But let's have DZ try and join first. And to be fair, DZ was here before both you guys, so I think he should at least be in the match more than anybody.
Hey, Tripod. Tripod, you there?
Untamed guy, green buddy.
You're gonna lose the first. In the meantime, we want to remind everybody watching to follow us here on Twitch. We understand we have a couple new followers, hoping that continues. Right. So please do so, and we thank you for being patient with us. Still to come... Four matches, including two championship matches. COO Brutality getting online. Hello. All right, so DZ's on the game. We're going to invite him. Hey, Jumper Magnum, if you are listening on the stream, I don't know if you are, but if you are, because I want to be fair to you, there is probably a good chance you are not going to get a match. And I say that because you are a Superstardom guy, and unless there's any connection issues that happen tonight, you probably won't be in the Superstardom, a Superstardom match. I'm sorry, man. I really would love, I would have loved to have you, but just didn't work out. So in the meantime, guys, let's get back to that Money in the Bank qualifier we're going to be going for here. I made the match. And DZ, please go ahead and join first. And DZ's connecting. My goodness. You guys just saw... We don't want to do a one-on-one because... DZ said it's... That, I mean, that happens, though, I'd say. You want me to remake it again? Okay. DZ is in. Okay, so Tyron and Ebams, go ahead and try and join. See if we can detect a connection issue between certain people or if this is all good to go. I hope so too, DZ. DZ is in, Ebams. As I said, though, guys, make sure you follow us here on the network. The more followers, the better. The more you get the word out, the better it is. And, of course, continue to view us here. Next big number is 250. Tyron, yeah, Tyron, did you click join and, like, nothing happened?
I'm just waiting for it to load.
Okay. I was going to say, yeah, Tyron, it might end up doing that, like, for keeps. I don't know. I better start trying to fish around for more people here. Hate to have roadblocks like this in the middle of shows, but, I mean, they are... They're all part of the game that is WWE and EIF. Well, we may end up being stuck having to give another young guy an opportunity. Tyron Hunt would have been a great veteran presence to have here. But sometimes things do not work out, guys. So. That's a great idea, DZ. Put your AI in. Or give another opportunity to another young superstar. So, Tyron, you may not be able to play depending on how this works out. So, I'm going to remake the game. Master B, I want you to... Okay, Ebams. All right. Master B... I want you to try and join this game. Have you been watching on the network? All right, so you know what this match is. So Master B, DZ, and Ebams, go ahead and join. I'm going to invite Ebams back. Ew. You realize what you just said? Okay, and apparently there's somebody that is... How did he join? Alright. Well, that's not good. That's not good. King... Yeah, King Esquire, here, hold on, guys. King Esquire, man, look, man, first off, hey, you got a shout-out. Congrats on being on the network. Look, dude, we can definitely get you a match, and we can certainly get something to go for you here in EIF if you just give us a little bit of time. Probably not tonight, man, just because these are already pre-booked matches. that have been booked weeks in advance. But following tonight, if you want, actually just add me as a friend here on Xbox. And that goes for anybody that's watching here. And we can get you a match. So and start getting you matches. So hopefully that works out for you, man. In the meantime, obviously you're watching here on the network. So we certainly hope that you will enjoy tonight's broadcast. So let's go ahead and try and remake this game. And DZ, along with Ebams, who is back in here as Master B. Guys, the game is up. Go ahead and join. Yeah, no order, just join. You can't even make private games on here, though, can you? I was gonna say, yeah. So DZ is in first, still waiting upon Master B on Ebams. There we go. And like I said, Esquire, just add me, man. Oh, DZ. Oh, okay. That happens. All right, guys, so sorry it took a while there for this match to start up. Couple of replacements needed. But we have our guys now, Master B and Ebams. Who would have thought these two young superstars would be getting an opportunity to compete for a Money in the Bank qualifying match? But that is the case, EIF. Sometimes it's about being at the right place at the right time. It's how guys like COO Brutality ended up winning a Superstardom Championship just a couple of matches into his career. You know, just things happen out of nowhere, and you try to make the best of them. And that's what Master B and Ebams are going to look to do here tonight. So this is the featured match voted in. The other option was tag team tournament opener. These three guys are actually all on three separate teams in the tag team tournament opener. If one of their teams wins, they'll get a future main event shot. But if they win tonight, they are one step closer to a Money in the Bank briefcase. The following contest is a Money in the Bank qualifying match. Introducing first, from Cleveland, Ohio, standing in the bottom left corner, DZ. One taunt. Introducing next on the top turnbuckle, from New Jersey, Ebams. One taunt. And last, from Burlington, Vermont, Master B. One taunt and ding, ding, ding. Our second multi-man and final multi-man of the night is underway, starting it out with an arm drag for DZ to Master B. Ebams, back suplex delivered to DZ. And now Ebams running charge at Master B, who reverses him. A wild and frantic triple threat. By the way, guys, no weapons in this match. But the winner guaranteed in 5 weeks to be in a Money in the Bank ladder match at SummerSlam. EIF's 10th annual SummerSlam is our next pay-per-view, by the way, guys. Again, 5 weeks from tonight on Saturday, August 13th. And it is known as the second WrestleMania, people. Starts at noon, goes till midnight. All day, all night. And you're going to be there with us. We certainly hope you will. It's a really, really fun time. No parties like the summer. And nobody parties in the summer better than EIF when it comes to Twitch streams. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed your summer thus far in this scorching month of July that has become what it is in this triple threat Money in the Bank qualifying match. Fifth overall match, fourth on the main card. Still three more matches to come after this. In fact, guys, coming up next, it's another featured match, perhaps the featuring match, the top feature, Ratlux Hollywood Open Challenge, for the fifth time and for the first time on pay-per-view, as a monkey flip connects for Master B to DZ. Stomp on the ribs, DZ avoids it with a ring escape. DZ possibly, no weapons, DZ. Possibly the most intelligent of these three superstars. No weapons tonight, but if he wins this match, he can use the ladder as many times as he sees fit. On the 13th of August, Ebans with a dropkick to the back of DZ and now going towards Master B. Ebans, didn't you and Master B just have a one-on-one recently in EIF? Who won that? Master B. Of course, B's older brother, NBC, will be in the main event later on tonight, still to come. The time is getting closer. You can definitely tell. I'm sure Master is getting a little bit more panicky maybe as the time comes near for he and Jetstar's one-on-one for the Undisputed Superstardom Championship. We also have the Undisputed World Championship match to come. That's all following the Hollywood Open Invitational and this Money in the Bank qualifying match. What a beautiful springboard DDT from DZ. Ebams, great sell. Single leg breaker connects from DZ. Ebams with a little bit of sign language. He's just mad because this was the character he was supposed to be on Superstardom, not Neville. Yeah. Headbutt to the side of the head of Master B. Only way to win this because it is ED is by pinfall. Two of the final three matches on tonight's card are Superstardom. There was an even 4-4 guys, 4 EDs and 4 Superstardoms tonight. Both brands splitting action here on Victory Votes. And it does, of course, at the conclusion of tonight's event, bring the end to EIF Tour. So you will not have a show tomorrow. In fact, we will have a show next on Wednesday. And we're going to have two shows. It's a super show that night. 6 to 8, Superstardom. 8 to 10, ED. And by the way, that is Superstardom episode number 299. So the following week, not next week, but the following week, look out for some specials for Superstardom 300. It's our longest running weekly show, regular show in EIF. And Master B. Oh, big uppercut from DZ. Ebams, how many taunts have you done now? All right. Three taunts, all the same. All right, we beat our top by just one view thus far here, at least for tonight. 37 views live right now. Make sure you follow us here on the EIF Network. You can stay up to date with our breaking news as well on Twitter as DZ hits the keister hard on the canvas. Master B, this is your pay-per-view debut, is it not? Welcome in, kid. Look, you got 37 people watching you, big dog. Proud of you. Ebams with an elbow to DZ and another elbow, this time a more formal kind. Finishers in hand for all three superstars. DZ continuously trying to go for that springboard. It's not working for him. Master B to the turnbuckles, then the apron. Jab to DZ. Second jab, nobody home. Ebams walking around. You have to pin your opponent inside the ring, too. This is not like the match we saw earlier tonight, which was a false count anywhere match. That pinfall still ended up taking place in the ring. Ebams, are you out of taunts yet? Even my little brother who's watching, the Jey Uso representative, Braden has the night off, but he's still in the EIF arena tonight. Master B picking up DZ. And DZ throwing Master B off a reversal into the ring and an elbow over the face of B. DZ with a mystery partner, Master B teaming up with his brother NBC, and Ebams with former rival Headshot Killa, who you guys voted in to face Ratluck tonight. It's going to be a rematch in their Hollywood Open Challenge. And by you guys, I mean Headshot's family and friends, who can all be found within a 15-foot trailer vicinity. As DZ is hit with a belly-to-belly, that might have been too far, but... and I'm pretty sure Headshot's a faithful watcher of the EIF Network, so if you heard me, Headshot, I'm sorry, but hey, man, at least you have a chance to beat Ratluck tonight. And if he does, by the way, Ratluck will forfeit over one of his title shots to Headshot Killa. Ebams dropping the knee over the face of DZ. NBC Master B making his pay-per-view debut here. He could have fell into the rookie category to face Tripod, but that was Nexus Genesis who won that match, I might add. The speed of all three of these guys, hybrid-like superstars, that'll be helpful in the Money in the Bank ladder match. You have to remember the characters that would be represented there. DZ with Triple H. Master B with Dean Ambrose, the superstar who won Money in the Bank this year in the WWE, and Ebams with Neville. So Triple H might be the odd man out in Money in the Bank situations. Of course, Triple H, though, main event stature is enormous. Those were the characters. And Ebams clipped DZ with a finisher. 1-2, and DZ able to power out of it, fortunately for him, because Master B was not going to break that up. And the reality of Ebams being in a Money in the Bank ladder match almost became a reality for the viewers watching at home. Can you imagine if Ebams, it's like Zack Ryder winning the IC title at Mania, but it happened. Can you imagine Ebams winning a Money in the Bank and knowing that guy is going to be a world champion in this league someday? Oh, DZ, nice strike there to Ebams. Master B is waking up Ebams. And DZ stops him. Nice springboard again for DZ. This time it wasn't the DDT, but a moonsault. And nice job from Ebam sliding out here. Depending on how the night ends, I don't know that you'd really want to go up against either of the current champions in EIF. SummerSlam is 5 weeks away, though. The title could change hands multiple times until then, including tonight, possibly. Ebams reversed. He is the only one that does not currently have a finisher anymore, but Master B has two. And Master B, monkey flip, DZ misses the dropkick. DZ with a single-footed dropkick, and now he has two finishers. Master B to the outside. DZ, oh, we saw Tribal do this move to Nexus a couple times. Arm breaker delivered. And so far, a lot of excitement going on, victory votes. Oh my goodness, what was that? Master B taken out from DZ. Well, I was just about to say that Nexus and Tribod probably have match of the night thus far, but that's gotta maybe be the moment of the night. As Ebams missing wildly, here comes DZ. Takedown and Master B back to both feet. Kick to the midsection and uppercut to follow. Well, Master, I'm surprised that B is okay right now. He's got to be a little shaken up after that. Right hand connects, and a right back kick. Off the rope, here comes B with a drop kick to the side of the head. DZ to the outside. DZ's a smart guy when it comes to multi-mans. Him winning this match could actually be a big threat. Oh, wait a minute. Finisher into a pinfall. No, that was a manual leverage pin. You fucking idiot. DZ, free taunt. Free taunt, DZ. It doesn't count against the taunt rule. There you go. We don't ask questions here, Aaron. We just continue to commentate. This triple threat continues. Ebams to the top turnbuckle. Elbow drop. DZ goes for the moonsault. Master B after. What the hell is going on? Well, DZ had Bam set up for a dive for Master B. The Headshot Killer is the X Division champion, Aaron, who's not able to be heard here on the broadcast. But either way, X Division champion is in action next. He's the only guy who doesn't have to defend the title. In fact, Master B, though, is the number one contender for the X Division championship. DZ, finisher zigzag to Master B. He's got to get over there and roll him over, though. Oh, but wait a minute. No, he doesn't. He could take out Ebams right now. And Ebams with a reversal. Bro kick. Finisher reversed. DZ. And a smart move from DZ. Irish whip strongly to Ebams on the outside. DZ can pin Master B to qualify for Money in the Bank. Two and no, not just yet. Great opportunity for DZ right there. DZ reversed by Master. Ebams missing. To the outside goes DZ. The action tough to keep up with here. You gotta wonder if these guys are gonna carry over this fast-paced action into a ladder match. That might help them out. And, oh, Master B was hoping his finisher there could have led him to a Money in the Bank at his SummerSlam debut. In fact, this would be the SummerSlam debut for both Ebams and Master B this year. Ebams joining EIF this past October. DZ with a finisher! But wait a minute, Master B's getting up! DZ's got to get him in! Oh, DZ may have regretted going for that pinfall right away there. Good clothesline from B. B with three finishers. Ebams still with zero after getting that bro kick reversed by DZ. And this is really where DZ has the advantage too, just given the quality of the opponents he has. No doubt that Master B and Ebams have came on as two premier rookies, but it's the inexperience that makes it difficult for them right now. Master B, strong Irish whip to... Oh, DZ did not go for a finisher. Master B might have thought it was going to be. DZ is out of stamina. I don't know if Master B realizes that. Monkey flip connects. And B running right into a backbreaker from Ebams. Stomp onto the chest from Ebams to Master B. Ebams clubbing blow to B. And then a big enziguri delivered to DZ. Ebams just trying to figure out what to do next. Both men down, and he's going to take a step down to the outside. And what is this? Long move from Master B. Oh, wait a minute. Ebams. Wrong guy. Master B, though, got the right one. Finisher attitude adjustment. One, two, and no. Ebams got the shoulder up right before DZ might have been able to break it up in time. And Master B again! Attitude adjustment! He goes right into the pinfall, though, and that's going to play immediately into the hands of the veteran superstar DZ. DZ with a finisher! It's Rock Cena, WrestleMania 29 again. Ebams goes for the pin. Oh, man. I say 29 because there was definitely more finishers. John Cena hit four finishers on The Rock that night. He almost lost by the finisher count. Master B, I don't think that's a finisher, but he can mock a pin to get DZ to call the bluff and get in the ring. And what is DZ thinking now? From the middle rope, beautiful moonsault connects. Ebams with a drop kick. And it's like two and a half men, two down, one groggy in the turnbuckles. But Ebams is going to take advantage. I'm not going to call him for a stall there, DZ, because he was down. German suplex from Ebams. Not to say that you would have asked for one, but there's my reasoning. Well, we talked about Nexus and Tribud being a match of the night. This one could be a close contender. It's been a really good match here. And, oh, different move from Ebams. I don't know how it's a comfortable one for him, but it's different. And DZ now switching over to the finisher, but it was not a finisher. He was hoping, though, Master B would buy into it. And here comes Ebams. Reverse into a leverage pin for DZ. And Master B immediately dropping that out of an opportunity. You can win off reversal leverage pins in this match, guys. DZ gets his finisher reversed. Ebams so close to a signature, and instead he's going to get a finisher because Master B went for a finisher on Ebams. Then rocks him in the jaw with a springboard. These guys just keep going. It's almost like that Shinsuke and Sami Zayn match at TakeOver Dallas, the Fight Forever chance. These guys might end up actually doing that. Oh, this is just Master B's pay-per-view debut. Way to have one. His brother's involved in what's called by many match of the year at Superstars Reborn back in May. DZ, neck breaker connects. Stomp onto the ribs of Ebams. B trying to get to his feet. DZ with a forearm to the back of him. And Master B with a reversal. Master B, as we mentioned, number one contender for Headshot Killa's X Division Championship. Those guys are going to collide 2 weeks from tonight. It's not a pay-per-view, but an EIF special, EIF X1, the debut of the X events. X1 Saturday, July 23rd, X marking the spot on many maps, but in this case, a decade in EIF, as we are currently in the midst of our 10th year as an online wrestling league. July 23rd, I said. Anyway, Ebams reversed. And I think it was a finisher reversal. And, oh, smart move there from Master B. Look at a guy learning on the job. He has got a brother in NBC who's a two-time undisputed Superstardom champion as well as a former U.S. champion, as is Ebams, had the X Division to that. And Master B could be adding that title to his trophy case. It would be the first one in that collection under the Extreme International Fighting trademark. Arm drag delivered for Master B. DZ was thinking zigzag and a warp will get it for him. And here goes DZ. One, two, and DZ is headed to SummerSlam, and he will compete in the Money in the Bank ladder match. DZ, the veteran superstar and the brain that won him this match, that could win him a briefcase to guarantee himself back in the main event where he wants to be. DZ is headed to SummerSlam 10 next month, but a hell of a match and a hell of an effort too from Ebams and Master B. I mean, and this match, just pacing-wise, was fast and furious. We said that would maybe happen in victory votes. It definitely did right there. Ratluck, are you ready? No, I know. Did you get my text? Oh, yeah. I just sent you a text on the phone like 5 minutes ago. All right, guys. So, great match there. That's going to end the multi-mans for tonight, but it's time for the big three. And it starts with the pay-per-view debut of the Hollywood Open Challenge. By popular demand, Ratluck had embarked on a journey that would involve him going toe-to-toe with new faces in EIF, newcomers, young superstars, first-year superstars, and a young boy named Headshot Killa was the first to accept that challenge several weeks ago. Now Headshot has been granted a rematch due to the voting polls that state so. So Headshot, with a second opportunity to defeat Ratluck and earn a title shot, and possibly even more important, the respect of the 2016 Hall of Fame inductee. And so we are just waiting. Oh, sorry, Headshot. Hey, man, what's more important, winning this match or that? That's true, though. But anyway, all right, who's watching this? All right.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Anyway, all right. So Ebams will be watching with me, assuming that connection does work out. And it will be Ratluck going one-on-one with Headshot Killa, the fifth Hollywood Open Challenge. Ratluck remains undefeated. Headshot looking to put a dent in the second half of his record. Of course, that is a big goose egg on that side. Guys, the match is up. The Hollywood Open Challenge is ready. Since Headshot, Ratluck has defeated Ebams, Master B, and just recently on tour, Austin, the newcomer. Characters have been Kalisto, Neville, Ambrose, and Big Cass, Colin Cassidy. So Ralek will once again be at a reversal disadvantage here, a 5-4 reversal ratio that favors Headshot Killa. Some controversy around the voting poll in this case, but Brutality has many times told me that I rigged the votes. Brew, I hope this further unvalidates, for lack of a better term, your belief in that. Ebams, go ahead and ready up. Ant-Man Loves Cheese 24. This pay-per-view's name is... Well, it should be right there for you, buddy. Victory Votes. It should be in our title. Aaron, you're a mod and you post that. Really? 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 Are you trying to name all of Headshot's relatives that are next to him? Oh. Anyway. All right. Frank. All right, so after I get counted out, Ebams will come in. In the meantime, guys, the following contest is the fifth installment for the Hollywood Open Challenge. If Ralek loses, he also loses one of his title shots. Introducing his challenger, from Mobile, Alabama, representing Kalisto, the current reigning EIF X Division champion, Headshot Killa. Mobile. Introducing his opponent from Battle Creek, Michigan, representing Chris Jericho, he is Hollywood Ralek. All right, guys. Ding, ding, ding. And so the fifth Hollywood Open Challenge begins. Headshot's second opportunity, probably his last one if he cannot beat Ralek here. Ralek to use a reversal instantly. Now Kalisto uses one, represented by Headshot, and Ralek retains offense. The drop kicks, baby, the drop kicks. Keeps offense again after another reversal from Headshot. Headshot now out of the reversal advantage. Spinning heel kick connects, and he does get a strike off on Rat. Stomp, Ralek trying to keep offense, Headshot off the rope, and Headshot this time gets offense. Anything you can do, I can do better. I say that like every time. Hurricane Rana connects for Headshot, who says, a misunderstanding there in the introductions. Headshot from Barnesdale, Alabama. You said ball of hail? What? Oh, Barnhill, Alabama. Okay. Barningdale? I don't understand. What Barning? Bargendale? Well, Headshot now angry at me, so the location of him we cannot pinpoint. But we do know that Headshot was groggy there, thinking about it a little bit. Hopefully Headshot and his gang members from Trailer Park Boys are here because they helped Headshot earn this vote. Running head scissor takedown delivered to Ralek. Headshot at no point denied that his friends helped him, by the way, guys. I just want to point that out. And over the top rope and out! Ralek getting powerbombed. What the fuck do you think I'm doing, buddy? Anyway, Headshot with one taunt. Pretty sure this is commentating, but either way, we continue. I digress, and Headshot does too. Ralek out of green, and Ralek has to be careful now. Ralek at no point said that there was anything off limits in terms of how he would lose a title shot if he lost the match, so disqualification could be factored in. We do know in our next contest there will not be disqualification. Deathlock and Hybrid Maniac Coming up next, the Undisputed World Championship and the first of our two main events, and they will be trapped inside of a steel cage. Headshot Killa with a head scissor takedown delivered to Ratluck. And Ratluck not doing quite as well as he did last time. Perhaps might be losing his first Hollywood Open Challenge loss. He's 4-0 to this point. Stomp on the ribs of Headshot. Second stomp. Third stomp. You know, Ratluck's Hollywood Open Challenge has, it's so high up on this card, maybe some people wondering about that really helps give Headshot a spotlight. But, you know, honestly, it's because Ratluck's Hollywood Open Challenge has really made headwaves. Even before it was on the stream just a couple nights ago, people had known about it. Even people outside of EIF talking about it sometimes. I mean, this is an important thing for these young guys, and it's a really different element that you don't see in a lot of the build-ups towards mainly championship matches, which is where the majority of pay-per-view cards focus around. Ratluck, no clean entry given from Headshot. You can expect Rat to return the favor if that ever becomes an option to him. Ratluck. Oh, Ratluck, clothesline power. Guys, Headshot is green barring Ratluck. Could you imagine? And Headshot with a reversal. And guys, Ratluck is out of reversals. If Headshot has enough time, he may be able to get a signature and a finisher off. There is the signature. Headshot Killa did not hit a finisher on Ratluck in the last match. It looked like he almost did with the Salido del Sol. This time, he will. STS connects into the pinfall. Is Headshot Killa about to green bar Ratluck? Two. And he almost did. Wow. I think that would have been the first time Ratluck was green barred in this game, and of all people, Headshot Killa to do it. Say what you want about how he got the votes, but maybe he wanted this because Headshot may have believed in himself that he knows he can beat Ratluck. And after the way this match has been going thus far, I got to think I might be agreeing with Headshot. Stomp into the heart of Ratluck. Headshot's tag team partner Ebam's watching on in the upcoming tag team tournament. Ratluck and Aaron are a team. Aaron and involved in a no contest earlier tonight. Ratluck hoping he can get a win for his team here tonight, as is Headshot after Ebam's dropped a Money in the Bank qualifier moments ago. Ratluck back to the apron. Count here. Ratluck can lose this match by count out. Missile dropkick to come in the ring. It doesn't work for him. Headshot with a kick to the lower back of Ratluck. Off the rope. Body splash connects. Just shocked right now. I mean, the last pay-per-view Ratluck was in, he did not have a great outing against Hybrid Maniac. That was ED. Ratluck was hoping for different results tonight. Big Inzaghi will help his case. You guys can tell Headshot clearly going for the green bar still. I don't know if he'll have it after this. Neckbreaker connects. He does not. So Ratluck has Headshot out of green. I sometimes say that can be better in a way because it gives you an opportunity to focus more on the match. Sometimes people get so excited about those green bars. We did see Wicked, though, pull off one successfully earlier in his United States Championship defense. Headshot with a snapmare and a kick to the back of Ratluck. Ratluck brought up to both feet. Another signature connecting for Headshot Killa. And Ratluck this time with three reversals back. Headshot. Oh, Headshot's got to be careful here. Ratluck's got to get on groggy. Free move. Yep, free move. Free move. He wasn't on groggy. Yep, free move. You walked away and he was still... He still was groggy, Headshot. You can't, dude. If they're groggy, I'm sure... I was going to say, yeah, everybody in the thing's probably going to agree with me. So it's one free grapple for Ratluck. Well, Ratluck going up against rookies, this is one of those things that can happen. Suplex delivered, and there's the ignorant pinfall from Ratluck. And that's one thing, you know, if you're Ratluck, knowing that you're a veteran, getting the upper hand in the knowledge of the rule department. And while Ratluck maintains the offense in the meantime, oh, Headshot using a reversal, and Ratluck kept offense, and now it's going to be a 4-1 reversal advantage, assuming Rat gets that reversal, and there it is. So where Headshot had a good lead in the reversals, now Ratluck does. I apologize for my laugh in the commentary. The party has broke out into hysteria. of some country folk. Oh, ignorant slap from Ratluck. Great comeback here from the Hollywood movie star. A couple of elbows practically denting through the mask and into the skull of Headshot's superstardom character, Kalisto. Tyron, it's metaphor through commentary. It happens. Headshot missing the Hurricane Rana. Tyron went from potentially being a match cannon to just a commentary plug here that cannot be heard on the network. Salido del Sol, and this time it connected again. One, two, Headshot's gonna pin Ratluck now. Ratluck, still in it. Oh, and Ratluck goes early on the grapple, and Headshot maintains offense off a reversal Hurricane Rod to Ratluck into the ropes. Ratluck moves, so that is a legal strike for Headshot. It's all good. Headshot again after Ratluck makes movement. Walking a tightrope there on the rules, but they're going to count it. And now, oh man, parties are hard to commentate in when you have certain people in here, but Headshot with a taunt. Is it going to take him too long? Ratluck goes charging, not able to reach on the grapple, but he does get him on the Irish whip. Headshot now face first into the turnbuckle reversal. He's out of reversals, and that does not bode well for Headshot. He still has some yellow. Does Ratluck elect to use a move anyway? He does not, but he is going to get some offense here. Headshot on the middle rope, and Ratluck beginning to chug along here off the rope, and he drops all the weight onto the middle rope where Headshot's throat lied. And Ratluck waking up Headshot. Headshot just got a reversal back, though. And Ratluck does not go for the finisher. He might have been hoping that Headshot would still bite on it, but he did not. At one point, it looked like Ratluck was going to get green barred in this match, and now it's practically even. 2-0 finisher count, though, is where the match is unequal, and it does favor the challenger. Headshot, the first person in the Hollywood Open Challenge to hit multiple finishers in a match on Ratluck. Ratluck kicked out of both, though. Headshot killer almost brought to his feet, and Ratluck again trying to remind Headshot. This is the big leagues, and this is not one of the X Division challengers. Far away from the X Division. They may be in the same league, may bear the same name of EIF, but it is like going across the planet, practically, in terms of skill, night and day. So Ratluck bringing Headshot back to his feet. A kick to the midsection. Suplex. Headshot with a knee to the top of the head. Spinning heel kick. Ratluck with a reversal. Ratluck turns him around, and a scoop slam connects. Ratluck telling Headshot what to do next. These two exhausted now as this Hollywood Open Challenge continues. And one other thing about the Hollywood Open Challenge is Ratluck, through all of them, has actually had very good matches, too. And that's one great thing. It's not only just the quantity of Ratluck being 4-0, trying to pursue a 5-0 record in this. He's given away a title shot if you can beat him, and he's putting on very good matches. Ratluck showing the newer talent what you need to do to stick here. Ratluck known for quality matchups, and this one is no different. I believe that was two, Ratluck. But the production truck might tell me otherwise if that was Ratluck's second taunt. Or not. Actually, wait, it is one. Yeah, now I just thought of that. It is one. Sorry. That is your first taunt, Ratluck. My apologies. As Ratluck is thrown down, and Headshot again connecting with the signature. He can't pin off of those. Ratluck with a forearm to the face. Codebreaker reversed! And Ratluck keeps the offense. Wait a minute. Ratluck keeps the offense, and Headshot is out of reversals. What will Ratluck go for? Does he go for the code breaker, or does he try to make Headshot submit as he did in the first match? And he's going to go for the lion tamer. He's bending back on the spine of Headshot. Headshot has nowhere to go. He's got to stay in this match. First finisher on Headshot. Is Headshot going to be able to keep the Hollywood Open Challenge going? And he does. He wasn't able to last time, but this time he does. And Ratluck You could see as he was down on one knee, a look of disbelief. Headshot is still in this match. Dancing on my feet. Doop, 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 doop. Two taunts. That lion tamer so much more vicious than the Walls of Jericho, which is a double-legged Boston crab. His torque on the spine worse than the Walls of Jericho, as I said, and headshot somehow able to stay alive. And, again, nowhere near the ropes there. I mean, he was in a tough position. Spinning heel kick. Oh, wait a minute. They both missed, but headshot ended up getting the offense. Salido del Sol. No. Salido del no. Ratluck with the finisher reversal. First one of the match for him. Ratluck picking up headshot. Spinning heel kick connects. And, you look at headshot, an X Division champion of one time right now, as well as... Headshot fell right into Ratluck's hands. But, you look at Headshot, one-time champ, 3.5 months tenured in EIF compared to Ratluck, 6 years, Hall of Fame, multi-time undisputed world champion, multi-time undisputed superstar champion, about 20 reigns with all his title reigns included throughout EIF. But, this is something that the superstars have to accept to go into. Headshot was feeling very confident the first probably 5, maybe even as much as almost 10 minutes into this match, but times have changed. Spin around the back fist connects for Ratluck. Headshot had all the time to reverse and chose not to. Ratluck, smart move now for Rat to build up stamina. He cannot hit that lion tamer right there, though. It would be beyond the rule. Now, backbreaker delivered from Ratluck. Untamed, you might have to get kicked out of the party, dude. You're too funny. Sorry about that, guys. I said earlier on tour, sinuses, man. Been a rough week for allergies. The weather has just heated up ridiculously in the 90s almost every day now. And, we talked about this a couple times. Headshot not giving Ratluck clean entry. Well, I don't think Ratluck's going to be helping Headshot out either. Headshot at the count of 6. And Headshot in the ring. Ratluck running. No offense for Headshot because no clean entry given by Ratluck. Don't blame him. 4-2 reversal advantage in favor of Ratluck. A trio of stomps. He'll be careful on the next one he attempts. Maybe not. You didn't realize that was an auto reversal? What are you doing? Dropkick connects. I was just talking to Ann about this. I can't believe Ratluck made that mistake. That almost is never seen. Signature in hand for Ratluck. So Headshot got a freebie there, but it isn't going to help him out too much because Ratluck has the offense yet again. Jawbreaker reversal for Headshot. Maybe thinking Salido del Sol. I think he is. He is. And Ratluck for the second time has reversed it. Into the final hour of our regularly scheduled pay-per-view. And it has been a pay-per-view for sure tonight, guys. Great match between Headshot and Ratluck here. Far better than their first one was. You guys know how to do it. Wait till we're on the stream. Pay-per-view, guys. Good job. Free TV don't get this. And now Headshot. With a taunt. Oh, I broke kayfabe. No. Headshot just continuing the onslaught here. Don't forget, guys, coming up next, 2 world championships on the line in our doubleheader main events. Headshot with a headlock. Rolling around with Ratluck and then a kick to the chest to keep the Hollywood superstar down. Well, Headshot with another taunt. Is that 4 or 5? Okay. So it's a 4-2 taunt count. And it is a 2-1 finisher count in favor of Headshot. Pace beginning to slow up a bit here, guys, just because these two are practically exhausted. I hope not. It's a terrible name for a girlfriend. Hi, Jolton. Headshot to the outside. Not sure that's a smart idea. Ralek with his third taunt. No, it's your third. You did the dance on your feet twice. Five. Count at five. Headshot, I believe, got in last time at the count of seven. This time, six. And yet again, same move as last time when he was welcomed in, a float over neck breaker. Ralek with a stomp and headshot out of reversals. So this pace again, slowing up now, guys, because re-strategizing now his headshot. Oh no, headshot. Got to be careful he doesn't lose by disqualification now. This match been going on for 20 minutes now, people. Hollywood Open Challenge. Ralek and Headshot Killa. Another great match on tonight's Victory Votes card. We talked about how good it was looking. So far, the execution, for the most part, has been doing very well. But Headshot continuously doing this, and he's out of taunts now. Well, now Headshot's beginning to pull an E-Bams now. Be the heel. Go to the outside. Take the time up. Thanks to the Oshawa guy that says, so is EIF Carney. I'm a legend. Thank you. By Hall of Fame standards, I technically am, so thank you. So, Headshot got in at six last time, seven the time before. Let's see, the referee sometimes... Oh, he was at the seven count, silent seven. Ralek with a bulldog once again. Spinorama back fist. I'm going to call you there, Rat. I thought that was too long. Sorry, man. I'm still going to call it. Yeah, you got the reversal advantage, bro. The longer... Headshot go. You got one grapple, brother. What are you going to do? All right, there you go. I guess that counts. All right. I know it was a tough call, Hybrid. I know, but then again, Hybrid, he is your friend, so it's hard to take your word, though. You know what I mean? I'm just saying it was a tough call, but yeah, it's not. Honestly, it's not like he got a free finisher done to him. That's how I look at it. He's got the offense right now. Or so he does. Headshot with the neckbreaker reversal. Ralek with a dropkick. And Ralek with the lion tamer, and yet again is in the center of the ring. I don't think Headshot was ready for it, and I don't know if he's going to be ready to continue this match. Official asking Headshot, does he submit? Headshot's still in it, and he stayed in it. You gotta be kidding me. Wow. Four taunts for Ralek. Headshot has used all five of his. I mean, Headshot has got to be... I don't know how he's still in it. He's got to be spent right now. These matches have been great. This match has been great. Well, we talked about Nexus and Tripod being great. Then you have the Money in the Bank qualifier. Now you have this. Salido del Sol connects. 3-2 finisher count. Headshot and Ratlock used resiliency. Oh, man. Wow. Absolute great. This might be the best match Headshot's wrestled in his career. It's a brief one at that, but still. 24-minute match so far. Ralek, scoop out slam. They continue to play on here. Oof. I mean, Ralek, you see they're just tirelessly just shoving the boot into the face of Headshot, just trying to keep him down right now. Well, the main events are certainly going to have to live up to some tough matches that we've seen throughout our mid and undercard here tonight. Nice suplex from Ratlock. I was going to say, Aaron, yeah, I agree with you, man. Talking to you right now, I know obviously viewers can't hear. I think this has been a really good show so far, really good pay-per-view. So Ratluck hoping to continue that trend and make it an even better night for him. Yeah, well, we were saying, you know, this card, before going on air, and even when we did go on air then, we said, you know, this card, possibly the best card in 2016 other than WrestleMania going into it. So Victory Vote's known year to year to be one of those really good pay-per-views, and that is no knock in any way to anybody, just because there are so many matches in this year. I mean, go back to Superstars Reborn, as I said, the Hell in a Cell main event, NBC winning his first championship there. I mean, it's a phenomenal match. It really is. You know, but match by match, just how great the quality has been. I mean, these guys, they keep on fighting. 26 minutes, by the way, for those counting. Ratluck with an elbow drop over the heart of Headshot Killer. Make it two. Heartbreak elbow, dare I say. And Ratluck reversed. Headshot reversed by Ratluck. And oh, clothesline over the top rope goes Headshot. And this time Ratluck is going to go to the outside with Headshot Killer. It was a different clothesline than what we're used to, and it did painfully send Headshot to the outside. And now we get another different element, some outside action, not for long though. And roll Ratluck with a baseball slide. And wait a minute. You got to wonder if Ratluck's at all threatened by Headshot right now. He could be going for the win like this. And he does let up, though. I was wondering if he would just continue to baseball slide Headshot out of this match. Headshot in the ring. Ratluck running. Oh, Ratluck didn't get it this time, and he got hung up. Ratluck so close to that fourth reversal. Will he allow it? No, he will not. They both play bumper cars. Forearm to the back from Ratluck. Headshot. Holding in the leg and then a suplex. Ratluck getting suplexed. His legs caught the middle rope there. Might make it harder for him to hit that lion tamer. He's hit twice so far. Kudos to Headshot for getting out of it. Ratluck and Headshot both run their separate ways and then back toward each other with Ratluck gaining the upper hand. And Headshot is out of reversals. Ratluck can stall, but he did not stall long enough. And now Ratluck cannot stall, at least outside of the EIF's 4-second rule. Four fast seconds, I might add. An example, if Ratluck would have hit a finisher right there, it would have been a free move for Headshot. If he would have hit a finisher, it would have been enough moves for Headshot to at least hit a signature and obtain a finisher of his own. Headshot is out of reversals, and so is Ratluck, and Ratluck has the upper hand now. Does he have the stamina to hit a third Lion Tamer? No, he does not, but he does hit a code breaker, and it's a 3-3 finisher count. First pinfall attempt for Ratluck this evening. One, two, and Headshot gets the shoulder up. We keep going. My goodness. Well, it looks like we might be going to overtime. I feel like that in a way is sometimes actually a lot of times it's expected here on the network. Oh, Headshot throwing the boot off of Ratluck, especially for pay-per-views. Yeah, but can you really complain when you got quality like this? Ratluck, suplex into a pinfall. He'll have to let go, which he does. Dropping down to a knee, Headshot back up. Keeping an eye on the clock here, waiting for it to hit 10:12, and there it just did. That means this match has officially been a 30-minute match. A half an hour of these two battling. I don't know, guys. I mean, we've had a couple of great matches here tonight. Thus far, I don't know, man. This one might take the cake. Ratluck to the top turnbuckle. He'll quickly drop down. Our official warns him. Ratluck will stick with the official's decision there. Spinarama back fist connecting for Ratluck once more. Headshot not electing to use those reversals. And, oh, Ratluck almost caught off the rope, and he's able to maintain the offense. And these are the matches, though. The longer they go, guys, it makes it more and more difficult on the young superstars like Headshot because they're not used to going the distance like this. May I remind you guys, 2 years ago, as Headshot does hit a signature, 2 years ago, Ratluck was involved in a one-hour-long co-main event of WrestleMania. If that isn't enough pressure and enough distance to go, not to mention the following year it was over an hour, Ratluck, and he won that one, you know, I mean, Ratluck might be maybe second to hybrid, if not none, is the most endured superstar in this league. He knows what to do, and headshot does not. He gets hit with a code breaker, 4-3 finisher count. 1-2, and no, this match continues. Wow. You just can't say it enough. 4-3 finisher count. This is one of those moments, you know, a lot of times people are watching the network. Sometimes you're playing a game in the background. You got TV on elsewhere. You know, this is one of those matches. You stop and drop everything else just to continue to watch this excellent contest between these two competitors. Ratluck and Headshot Killer, an unlikely duo to put on match of the year chemistry, and it has been just that. 4-1 reversals in favor of Ratluck, though. Oh, no. No way. I hope it's Ebam's. I hope that isn't a split screen. Ebam, yeah, Ebam's disconnected. All right, guys, hold on. Ebam's, he is not important in this match right now, so let's just keep an eye and make sure there's no split screen here, guys. Ratluck, you're on the ground, right? And Headshot's standing there. He's backed up. Now you're crawling away. He just tried to hit you. All right, and he kicked you. Okay, so, all right. So, guys, we'll just pay close attention here. Nobody wants the match to end like that. Ebam's, his front row seat is apparently security exited him out. Ebam's talked about his match with Jumper v. Magnum, which, by the way, went 33 minutes. Headshot Killer, Salida del Sol reversed. This match now hit 34 minutes. Or, I'm sorry, 33 minutes. My apologies. So it has tied that. I'm just commentating here. I'm actually sweating bullets right now. Just a very entertaining matchup. Twist and turn everywhere you go. But Headshot is out of reversals. Tries to run away. Ratluck with a scoop slam. Ratluck's got to hurry. What is he doing? He's taking way too much time. Headshot nearly with that reversal back. No. 5-3 finisher count for Ratluck. Third time in terms of the pinfall. Will it be the charm? 2. And Headshot keeps it going. The 7 finisher count could be and could end up being used here, but Headshot is hoping that if it does get used, it's against Ratluck. Yet again, the signature again connecting. Some awkward grappling attempts between the two superstars, but Headshot has successfully hit that signature several times, but look at the amount of reversals Ratluck has. Break it down to 3. Ratluck with a dropkick. Ratluck picking up Headshot again. Headshot with a reversal. What is Headshot? Oh, that's clean. Salida del Sol, 5-4. Weirdest wake-up taunt I've seen, 2. And, oh, Ratluck keeps the match going. I don't know how that counts as a wake-up taunt, but my goodness, and they both miss their diving moves there. Scoop and a slam from Ratluck. 35-minute match. Ratluck having a repeat of WrestleMania 7 here. How are the main events going to live up to this? And a snap suplex connects from Ratluck. A different move. We actually haven't seen that move as much in this match, so it's crazy this match can go on that long, just as it's crazy as Ratluck can be here for this long, this many years, and still get new opportunities against new opponents. And I'll tell you something, guys. You know, Ratluck, there's times where you think maybe he goes easy on the newer guys. That might have been the case earlier. We don't know. I can tell you right now, Ratluck is giving it his all to win this match. He is giving Headshot 110%. So if Headshot wins, he leaves this match as the better man. You know, we were all critiquing Headshot getting voted in, maybe by his friends, some skeptical voting. But honestly, I got to wonder if Nexus or Jumper would have put up this kind of match. Sometimes things happen for a reason. It's a 5-4 finisher count right now in favor of Ratluck. The best Hollywood Open challenge to date. I mean, their opening matchup that started this Hollywood Open challenge a few weeks back doesn't even hold a candle to this. Look at Hedgehog. I mean, guys, he's practically lifeless now. Even Ratluck, he's not doing a lot of running strikes right now. I mean, he's spent too much of himself. But yet, Ratluck from the top rope, axe handle, and it clipped Hedgehog. Yet again, something different for Ratluck in this match. And, oh, Ratluck maybe Lion Tamer now. 5-4 finisher count in favor of Rat, who does have the finisher. And he begins to wake up Hedgehog Killa. Inzaghi, but Hedgehog saw the hesitation, and he thought it might have been more than that. Plated chops, Hedgehog again on the reversal. Spinning heel kick again, Ratluck with the reversal. Hedgehog off the rope, running, somehow still has the speed to do it, and he takes down Ratluck. Oh man, heavy breathing, I think, between these two and myself here. This is a way to lose your voice. Standing moonsault connects for Hedgehog Killa. And Hedgehog, Irish whipping Ratluck, putting him on the apron. And yet again, these two go to the outside over the top rope, power bomb. And I don't know, Ratluck actually might have caught part of that chair outside. Could be a game changer here. Referee counting, I mean, how much time does Ratluck have left? How much energy does Ratluck have? And I don't know how Ratluck got him there. And Ratluck with a suplex, standing vertical suplex, into another ignorant pin. Oh, Hedgehog Killa still a ways right now, playing the running game, and they both miss each other. Numerous times. Oh, wait a minute, the referee got involved. Snap suplex, Ratluck did it to Hedgehog. Hedgehog simply returning the favor now. Hedgehog Killa with a stomp onto the back of Ratluck. How much longer are these two men going to stand the test of time against each other? They both run away and still just have that ability in them to continue to go. Less than 40 minutes scheduled in our regular 3-hour block, 4-hour including the pre-show. We told you guys this was going to be a good one. I don't even know that we saw it being this good. Hedgehog off the rope. Off the rope again. Oh, Ratluck caught him. Kick to the midsection. And Hedgehog using a reversal. Hedgehog has that signature again, which he's hit so many times. By the way, 10:22, this match has just hit 40 minutes. We talked about Fight Forever and the Money in the Bank qualifier. What about this? Might be the longest match we've seen here on 2K16. Ratluck with the headlock applied. Snapping suplex connects. Hedgehog Killa again connecting with the signature. He's got to have done that at least 6 or 7 times at this point. But, I mean, what is Hedgehog thinking next? Ratluck using a reversal. Missing the elbow. Dropkick does connect. I think Hedgehog was thinking Salido del Sol. It would have evened up the finisher count. Ratluck has 5 finishers hit, and he has 2 stored. That is enough to win the match via the finisher count mercy rule of 7 finishers. Hedgehog out of reversals and smartly going to the outside. which has happened so many times. I mean, my goodness, you got to wonder how this match is still going on. Headshot back in. Kick misses. Here comes Headshot. He's going to go for that really weird one again. Selena Del Sol, 5-5 finisher count. One, two, does he win the Hollywood Open Challenge? He did! Headshot beat Ratlock! Headshot Killer just beat Ratlock in a 41-minute spectacle. You have got to be kidding me. 5-5 finisher count, and Headshot, with all five of them coming by SDS, has just defeated an EIF Hall of Famer and a multi-time world champion on both brands. That is the biggest win and match of this kid's young career. And I wish I could say I'm speechless, but 1,000 words or more coming out because of how great this match was. A picture is worth 1,000 words. Well, that match may be worth 1,000,000. Match of the night by far, and a stellar performance by these two individuals. Headshot has earned himself a title shot gifted by Ratlock, and while clean entry was not gifted by either, which started off with Headshot, I certainly hope that he may have also won the respect of Ratlock. You can go back and forth there. Look at Ratlock's two lion tamers. And he went for pinfall moves, had three code breakers hit. Headshot just continued to keep coming back for more. And there was a point in the beginning of the match, Headshot looked like he might have green barred Ratlock. Looked like it would have been a very early and abrupt ending to this. Say what you want about the kid from down south in Alabama. Say what you want about the X Division title reign that he has. This guy could be a part of the future here in EIF, and it might have been solidified by that match right there. So, guys, I wish we could say that's the great way to go off, but you know what? We got two more matches here in what's been an awesome victory votes thus far, and they're both for world championships. We're going to take a timeout, a well-needed rest. Give us about 5 minutes or so here, guys, and we'll be right back on air for entrances for our two main events. And coming up next, it's the Undisputed World Championship. Deathlock and Hybrid Maniac will be trapped inside of a steel cage. We'll be back with more at Victory Votes.